All right, so I think I'm just getting on the stage again. So my name is Raullen. I'm CEO co-founder of IoTeX. You know, I'm so glad to have everybody here enjoying the conference, enjoying talking with other people and learn more about DePIN. But like we have a very, very special guest. Alvaro basically flew in from Lisbon. Not sure today or yesterday.
Yesterday.
Yeah. So he's kind of like one of the most important people in the DePIN space. I would leave like Alvaro to have a self-introduction.
Yeah, not so much. But I'm Alvaro. I'm the partner at Borderless, in charge of the DePIN funds. And yeah, but I started my career as an economist. Afterwards, I worked at Telefonica in the corporate venture capital, so very deep in telco. Eventually, in 2015, I did a master thesis about Bitcoin. So that's when, for me, I went down the rabbit hole, and yeah, started really. It made me understand, you know, what's the true potential of this technology. In economics, you know, it's something unprecedented, an asset with a limited supply and the most secure database that there was ever. So for me, it made me explore the other things around. Afterwards, DePIN for me was the best application of blockchain technology, but we will get into that later.
No, that's super cool. Actually, you know, I think Borderless has a long history about betting on DePIN, right? So I still have the impression, like around the year of maybe 2020, 2019. So you guys call this thing like a H5, right?
Right,
so we call it Machine 5, and some other people call it different names. So I'm so glad that everything kind of converged into DePIN, right?
Right. No, it's good that that we all got together around the DePIN name. It's good to have consistency and to have a name that represents. And at the end, you know, all this is decentralized physical infrastructure. So, I think it's a great name.
Okay, very cool. Yeah, I'm just curious, you know, any particular use cases or projects that convince Borderless or you personally, like a fully bet on this, like a DePIN thesis, even at a very early stage?
Right, so the story of DePIN and Borderless started with Helium. We were early investors in the project, and one of our managing partners deployed thousands of hotspots around the US back in the time of the Helium IoT network. So that's when we started analyzing DePIN, and really, for me, what really built the conviction of DePIN was seeing the initial rollout of the Helium IoT network. If we think about it, that was the largest infrastructure deployment that has ever happened in the history of mankind. It was unbelievable to see that network grow, and the token incentives obviously were the real secret sauce for that, right? But me, having experience in the telco world, trying to figure out what would happen for a telco to deploy such a network, it's something impossible. I mean, no centralized entity could do something like what Helium did back in the last cycle. So yeah, that's what really got me hooked into DePIN.
Right. That's interesting. Starting from Helium, you guys kind of building up your DePIN portfolio gradually, right? How many DePIN projects you guys invest into so far?
Yeah, we have over 25 DePIN projects.
Wow.
Yeah. So Helium, Nova Labs, XNet, Wi-Fi, Dava, Wairu, that on the wireless side, Demo, Natix, HiveMapper. I don't want to leave anyone outside. Of course, GeoNet, which today announced the raise of his newest round, which we congratulate, of course. WeatherXM, Ambient Network, BlockJoy, Render, Airwave, Filecoin, Akash Network, Peak, Pocket, Silencio, Winbits. So that are some, and I'm leaving some outside. So yeah, we've been backing this. You know, it's something interesting because in blockchain, in Web3, there's a problem, which is the volatility and the cyclicality of the prices, right?
Yeah.
And all projects suffer these. And for us, seeing all the value destruction that happened during 2022, 2023, and being able to support these projects in the down market, of course, it has been compensated by the market. So I really like how the market really compensates whoever maintains the conviction when the market is down. So that's something important, I think, to take care of.
Yeah, you know, as a seasoned like an investor, like what's your sort of like decision making process looks like? I'm sure like we have a lot of audience, they are just DePIN builders or builders to be, right? So they definitely like want to learn your kind of decision making process. Oh, is this a good project? Borderless want to, you know, bet on, or this is not?
Right, so we focus a lot on the demand side of the projects. What we think is that any project needs to bring value, and the value in DePIN networks typically is generated by the demand side. So when you see something, for example, Helium, right now Helium is growing the demand side at an astonishing rate. I think right now it's sitting at 50,000 subscribers and growing like crazy. This happened in under 3 months. So that's what we like to see in DePIN projects, growing demand side, because growing the supply side during a bull market is not so complicated, since there's all this hype and the token price helps a lot. But the demand side is the tricky part. And there has to be very good product market fit. There has to be demand for the project that you're trying to solve. And that's what really helps maintain the token price and maintain the project alive when the bear market comes, of course.
Yeah, sure. Back to like IoTeX a little bit more, right? So like IoTeX has been like one of the OG projects, very much focused on IoT blockchain, connecting the real world into blockchain space since 2018. So we have been, basically on the market for so long, so we basically know everybody, right? So definitely like we work very closely with Borderless. And the entire IoTeX is kind of evolving into its 2.0 phase, so which we will gradually announce our 2.0 kind of pieces. But we actually launched our new website. Did you see that? Do you like it?
It's amazing.
It's amazing, right? I like the idea. Like they have different Legos, basically putting together, trying to visualize what does like a modular sort of like a infrastructure looks like for DePIN builders. I like it so much. Yeah. And also, there's an amazing use. Basically, Borderless actually invested into IoTeX recently. So it's a big bet.
Yep.
Yeah. So, yep. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for your support, Alvaro.
IoTeX has been one of the most loyal projects in the DePIN category that we've seen in terms of maintaining and gathering the ecosystem together. With initiatives like the Web3 stream, that is a middleware for DePIN projects, which is very needed, because what we see is that many DePIN projects, the teams are very strong at what they build, the type of service that they produce, but in many cases the Web3 aspect of the projects is lacking behind. So IoTeX can help a lot on those, and can provide also economies of scale, in a sense, you don't need to develop the same piece for every different project. IoTeX can provide a lot of the middleware. That's really interesting as well. Of course, then with ecosystem tools like DePIN Scan, which provide a great way to have a proper overview of the market. The liquidity hub is something that many DePIN projects are leveraging. And that is helping provide liquidity for the tokens. And obviously, these conferences, which are the biggest conferences in the DePIN space, even during the deepest of the bear markets, and you guys have been able to maintain the conviction, do the proper treasury management to be able to finance all of these. So yeah, I congratulate you. It's great to be here.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So yeah, thank you so much for your support. Definitely like that means a lot to us, right? So because we have been very much committed to the space. We work with the DePIN builders, so we learn their pain points. So people says, builder says, oh, we don't have liquidity after TGE, then we just build like a liquidity hub for them. Then people says, oh, we don't have a way to do off-chain DePIN verification. That's kind of like a weird web stream gets started. I think it's had a lot of exciting stories down the road for sure. All right, so besides, you know, investing into IoTeX, right, any other great big announcement or news you are bringing to Denver this week?
Yeah, we are. So we are announcing that we are committing to invest $100 million in the next 4 years.
Wow.
In the DePIN space. Yeah.
Wow.
So
lots of people want to say hi. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I mean, it's obviously thanks to our limited partners that put the trust on us, on managing their funds. So for us, we have the full conviction on this ecosystem. It's growing. Right now, it's the main narrative and the main vertical, I would say, in Web3. And it kind of fits the story of blockchain technology, if we think about it. There's more similarity from Bitcoin and the DePIN project than with any other kind of vertical in Web3. At the end, some people say that Bitcoin was the first DePIN, and there's a lot of similarities.
I said it.
You said it?
I said it.
That's a great quote.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. No, and so yeah, apart from that, we are committing, so inside those 100 millions, we are committing 25 millions for our accelerator program, Array Labs, which will be led by Sean Carey, the ex-founder of the founder of Helium, which will be working alongside us and couldn't come sadly today with us. But Sean, if you're watching this, you'll have to say some words publicly about it.
Hi, Sean. Cool. Yeah. So you know, so once you have this, like, I think this is already your third funds, right? Yeah. So you have the first one, the second is DePIN fund, then this 100 mil funds, basically.
Yep.
In three. Okay. So with this sort of like this many funds, how would Borderless work with the IoTeX DePIN ecosystem even more closely?
You know, of course, we are going to invest in the IoTeX ecosystem. We see many interesting projects building on top of IoTeX. There's opportunities also for providing liquidity. So that's something that is very interesting opportunity. And yeah, obviously partnering with IoTeX gives us a very good view and brings us some of the best deal flow in DePIN projects. So I think it's a great synergy, and I'm very happy that we're gonna make this work.
Definitely, looking forward to it. And maybe my final question, right? So I want to leave a few minutes for the audience, since a lot of people want to say hi. So like, what's your suggestions to DePIN builders?
Yeah, so for DePIN builders, I think treasury management, I think it's one of the things that can be the difference between a project surviving for only one cycle or for several cycles. So being able to, you know, accumulate cash and fundraise when the market is up and when everybody's looking at us and everybody's talking about DePIN, it's important to then build when probably the lights shut up and we spend another 2 years of calm, which is the best time to build. You know, that's, I think, one of the best things that a founder can do. And then the other one is obviously finding a use case that provides value, that creates value and that solves a problem. I think if you do those two well, the future looks bright, yeah.
Yeah, DePIN is unstoppable for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's maybe take two questions from the audience, you know, after you hear this 100 mil big number, you know, if you, you want to have some questions, you know, go to Alvaro, go for it.
How do we submit the projects to you? Is there a channel, any way to connect with you?
Sure, yes, through our website, our socials, or just connecting with the team, we are all around here. So yeah, that's the best way. And yeah, happy to chat.
What do you think are the connections between DePIN and RVA and possible collaboration between those two segments?
Oh, you mean real world assets? So yeah, I think in there's a big connection between DePIN and RWA in the sensor space. For example, there's use cases that we are analyzing where you can put sensors in you know, barns that store grain, for example, to monitor that the grain is being maintained and that is being conserved at the proper temperature and humidity. So that's a case where you have a DePIN sensor custodying a real-world asset that is tokenized. So there's a lot of opportunities, I think. Also, you know, the DePIN infrastructure is also a real-world asset. So when financing real-world assets, investors can do it through DePIN networks. For example, telco networks like the Helium Wi-Fi network, that's some sort of real-world asset, right? So,
you know, to your question, I think like a lot of DePIN devices are actually like the real-world assets, right? Give you an example in Web2, a lot of people, so they just like finance a car and to drive Uber, basically to making money to pay back like the car loan. So they how they basically like doing the business. I think the same model applies, right? If we do have a web server version of Uber, and also we can connecting this one with maybe a lending protocol, so we can almost like implement the same thing here. Then this car basically become the real world assets that producing like a yield for investors who basically lending money to this driver. So that's kind of I think one use case I can think of right now.
Thank you.
Yeah, cool. Any other kind of final question? You know, sort of like when DePIN will go to the moon type of question. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I think
there we go.
What are you? I'm an investment advisor. So if I was going to advise my clients to look into a Web3 fund, what kind of you're spending the money over 4 years? How long do you expect the return from that?
We'll probably have to talk about this privately. We are an SEC regulated financial institution, so I think to your comment
to the moon.
Yeah, to the so I mean this is the time for DePIN. I think right now there's many mature projects that are bringing real revenue and providing real services, so that's what investors really look for. And yeah, we've gone through a first cycle where there was a lot of experimentation, but this cycle, it's if you know the Gartner curve, now we are in the plateau of productivity, right? And we are seeing a lot of projects bringing real revenue, burning tokens with that revenue and providing a lot of token value accrual, which is also propelling the tokens further up. So it's great. And it's obviously because, you know, blockchain technology, it's a perfect fit. I think DePIN, in fact, is the killer app of blockchain technology, of Web3. If we think about it, we are finally able to coordinate ourselves to create and deploy infrastructure. We are finally able to crowdsource all of that CapEx investment that, if done centrally, it needs a lot of debt financing, which is extremely costly, even more now with higher interest rates. So I think it's just the time. And now also we have high-performance blockchains such as IoTeX and many others that provide the perfect infrastructure layer that wasn't there before, right? Back in the last cycle, we've seen a lot of problems with blockchain performance. So the technology is mature enough, the market is, and the technology is also at a point where it's producing value. So I think now it's the best time to be building in this vertical, yeah. And there's a lot of attention as well. Not only from the investment side, but also from the research side. Definitely. We are seeing everybody talking about it. Yeah. So that's a very good tailwind for DePIN projects.
All right, that's very cool. You know, well put, actually. Thanks for sharing a lot of insights and also great words about IoTeX. You know, we are so excited to work closely with Borderless down the road.
Of course.
All right.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, thank you so much. All right.